As the Russia-Ukraine crisis drags on, more countries continue to come into the fray, armed with sanctions. Companies are closing up shop in Russia. People are taking to the streets or social media in chants of protest or solidarity, depending on what side they're on. For the people of Russia and Ukraine, the telling signs have hit them to the bone. For the rest of the world, it's only a matter of time before we begin to feel it too. Many aspects are going to be affected, and space isn't excluded. Russia and America have been at the helm of the space race for as long as most can remember, and Russia is good enough. You only need to ask about the first man in space, and you'd know just how good they are. But could the Russia-Ukraine war affect the James Webb Space Telescope and space agencies? You're about to find out. How is Russia connected to the James Webb Telescope? The James Webb Telescope is the latest feat in space history. It was a $10 billion project 30 years in the making. So when people had to gather to watch the launch on Christmas Day last year, they did it with hope and with much expectation. After all, the telescope was created to discover stars, galaxies, and planets, even habitable ones. However, what most didn't know was that the James Webb Telescope is a joint venture. The cost of production and the actual assemblage was split between three space agencies: NASA, the European Space Agency, and the Canadian Space Agency. The actions of these agencies were backed by up to 14 countries and Mother Russia inclusive. Russia has been part of a dual-party space agreement with the US for a while, so they have embarked on a couple of projects for each other. However, the Russia-Ukraine war has rubbed both parties in different ways, and it's safe to say that projects that involve the US and Russia might take a hit, the James Webb Telescope included. But the James Webb Telescope is just one of the space projects that could be affected by the current Russian-Ukrainian scuffle. The ExoMars Rover. The ExoMars project is a collaboration between the European Space Agency and Roscosmos, the Russian space agency. The mission consists of creating an orbiter and a rover that'll run specific operations on Mars. The orbiter has been up since 2016. The rover was meant to follow, but couldn't due to complications from the pandemic. The launch was moved to 2022, but that's no longer possible due to Russia being embroiled in a mass of international sanctions. Now the space launch could see yet another extension. Navigation satellites. Russia has bitten back actively against the international sanctions meted out against it by the international community by renouncing its involvement with the European spaceport in Kourou, French Guiana. This action leaves a backlog of space missions awaiting launch. Initially, they'd been scheduled to launch with the Russian Soyuz rocket, but can't now that Russia has suspended their involvement. Among these space missions are a pair of European navigation satellites scheduled for launch in April. These satellites are significant to Europe because they're part of a system of satellites that make up the Galileo navigational system, the European version of the GPS. Clearly, they'd have to look for other options now, and there aren't that much out there. OneWeb Internet Network. OneWeb is a UK company aiming to create a space-based internet network using satellites in low orbit. The Soyuz rocket was scheduled to take about a dozen satellites to space on the 2nd of March, but Roscosmos backed out on the D-Day, citing fears that OneWeb could use the launched satellites for military operations against them. They even went as far as asking OneWeb to sell their own part of the mission. OneWeb refused, and of course that meant Roscosmos was out of the deal. By now, you can guess what country is behind Roscosmos and the Soyuz rocket. Mother Russia. As the war continues to rage, there are estimations that more space missions involving Russia will be affected. Do you think Russia is involved in too many space missions? Let us know in the comments section. Drop a like if you haven't. Make sure you hit the subscribe and notifications button to stay updated on subsequent videos.